Hi everyone, it's Kasia from Taromap, and I'm trying to make a video about court cards and how to read them. Of course, I'm not going to put all the ideas that are out there into one short video. This might not be such a short video, so prepare. Grab a cuppa, and if you're interested in court cards or have problems how to read them, I will try to enlighten some issues here for you. Well, let's just start. So there's a general idea about reading court cards. There are a few different ways of looking at them. The most traditional way is to see them as people. So you see the king as an older man, the knight as a younger man, the page as a child or a very young man, and or women, and then the queen as a woman. I don't particularly like this way, but it's not even that I like it or I don't like it. It doesn't matter if I like it or don't like it. It works when you need to see the courts as people. But what I find confusing is that sometimes the king can be a woman and sometimes a queen can be a man. So the gender is not as important as the function the court cards are playing in the suits. So I want you to pay attention to this, that the king can be a man or a woman, but it's more about the energy that the king represents, that the king kind of gives out, that you should pay attention to. And the other way of reading court cards is as aspects of our psyche, of our personality. So, you know, you can behave as a king, you can behave as a queen, you can behave as a page, so it's a young, excitable person, or you can behave as a knight, you're on a mission, you have your tool ready, you know, you want to go off and explore and investigate, and you want to do it fast. And then another way of reading court cards is to read them as stages in a process of creation. And there are different schools, don't get me started. Tov deck, when I started investigating for court cards, it's quite interesting but deep. Marseille decks, all our authors use probably different association. I just kind of read into Hodorowski and how he sees the knights and the kings, and also the Rider-Waite, different associations again. So you can see the court cards as stages in the creation process. The most people would read the king as the master of a suit and the last kind of representation of it. With the kings, you can either associate it with element of fire or with the element of earth, when there is this kind of physical, grounded expression of your suit. Hodorowski changes this and gives the knight appears after the king. So you have the king, which is, yes, the master of its element, but then it's the knight that can transform and bring this element to another dimension, expand it. Maybe thus the black earth and the fertile ground of expansion and growth. And the king is usually seated on the throne, so it's quite traditional. Maybe it doesn't explore or doesn't feel like exploring anymore, whereas the knight is always on the horse and has a mission and can go off and explore. So this is a few ways of seeing the court cards, and now I'm going to try to bring them a little bit closer and show you a few different ways of playing with them. I just recorded this thing after I watched my video because I thought, oh, there is no kind of like a common thread to this. So if it's a bit disconnected to the rest of the video, forgive me, but let's move on. I'm going to start with Marseille decks because I think the court cards are quite nicely depicted in the traditional decks. And you can see kind of the progression of age a little bit. You can see the progression of masculine, feminine. It's historical, so we have only one female for kind of three males. But also I wanted to point out that, for example, Alejandro Jodorowsky swaps the meaning of the king and the knight. So usually we think that the king is the master of the suit and we connect it to the fire energy. Alexander Jodorowsky gives the knights the most important kind of role, as if they could take what the king knows and transport it and take it with and head over to explore further and to take this knowledge and with this fertile ground, you know, just get to new dimensions of that thing. So it's very interesting. For example, in his book, The Way of Tarot, there is a whole chapter on court cards, so the place of the figures, and he's got some ideas how to connect them to numerology and how to connect them to the minors. And he says, for example, that the pages, so we would think of pages as the youngest energy. They often represent children, young people, but also if you don't read court cards as people but as aspects of your psychological personality, you see pages as something which you just starting developing, as an open mind. You know, you kind of think of a child's attitude to things and about curiosity, and in some way maybe lack of decisiveness. Very often pages have their feet split apart, so one face is left, one face is right, which could point to like, oh, I don't know which way to go, but I want to see it all. And I found this amazing, just like from this book, Tarot Spreads by Barbara Moore, I found this very cool depiction of pages, and or in general of court cards. And pages would symbolize something new you should start learning about. So this is like spring energy, something which you want to investigate. Jodorowsky says that pages, through their posture, so let's just see. Yep, this one has also his feet apart. What about the Page of Wands? Well, he's a bit more focused on the future. He stares to the right and both of his feet are kind of ready to go. And Page of Cups, he's facing to the left, but also walking towards that direction. So water and fire, this opposition seems to be a bit more kind of focused on what they're doing, whereas earth and air, so another opposition, these two pages are kind of not quite sure which way to go. But so their posture in general is a little maybe confusing for us, what they want to show. It's like uncertainty between action and inaction. So page kind of corresponds to twos and threes. That's how Jodorowsky puts it. The queens, he says, they are in total union with their suit. So their position is between stability and temptation to change something. So he connects queens to fours and fives. And then he takes the kings, so not the knights, the kings, and they achieve full mastery of the element. That's true. Often they shown as the eldest in the suit. They mostly positioned on a throne. Or they all are positioned on the throne, all the kings. And but he puts them between pleasure and irresistible action, so between six and seven. And he then chooses knights as the figure situated between eight and nine, so going towards ten. because the action heralds the transformation of the ten of one cycle into another. They are surpassing the achieved perfection of the kings, and they are setting off on a journey to enter a new dimension. So they are like prophets or emissaries of their suits. They head towards the following suit to begin the new cycle. And that's why they all have horses, and that's why they all kind of armed and dressed in the way they are. I don't really read the knights this way. I think I stuck more with the Rider-Waite-Smith system. So I see pages as something new. I see pages as either younger people, but I very rarely actually read court cards as people, unless the context demands. But usually I see court cards as aspects of ourselves which we have to develop or worked with, or energy in the process, how and where the energy, at which stage the energy is right now. So page is something new you should start learning about. I love this. The knight is something you should do pretty quickly, because knights have horses, so they're the quickest of their suit. They can deliver messages very quickly. They have support very often, which can be represented by the horse, and they messengers of their suit. But also, as I mentioned at some point, I have another video about it, I will link it below. They always positioned on the very fertile ground, the black earth with a lot of plants growing. So in a way, I like what Hodorowsky writes, that the kings, yes, they mastered the element, but it's the knights who will take it and go with it to achieve another dimension. That in a way, kings are a bit immobile. They might be a little bit too old in their minds to see the possibility of taking the kingdom to another dimension. So who knows? And what's interesting is that also in Thoth system, there is no king, but the knight is like in a way the yod, so the fire of fire, or the fire of air, the fire. So the yod is the seat for all the letters, and it's knights that represent this fiery aspect of taking the suit to the next level. So that's quite interesting that the knights can gain another kind of another layer in their placement. But to follow my thought from the Barbara Moore book, so the page is something new you should start learning about. Knight, something you should do pretty quickly because they have those horses. Queen is something you need to nurture or take care of. Queens are usually connected to water element because they're feminine, they're receptive, they're looking after their suit. So this is something you need to nurture in yourself and take care of in your life or in yourself. And then the king, as that kind of head of the suit, this is something you need to master or take control of. So I love that this is giving you a practical ability to work with court cards. And the kings is something you need to master or take control of, because they are in control of their suits. So the knights you can do pretty quickly, but also you can think of them right now in the regards of this information I gave you before as something you might take to another dimension and something which you can grow and expand further. Whereas the kings, you're just mastering it and maybe looking at it from more traditional point of view. Whereas knights, you can, you know, give it a try to explore, to reach other dimensions. I love also when you look at Tarot de Marseille, you can check. So the King of Cups and the King of Coins seem quite older. And you can see that the King of Coins has beard in the body kind of color, and his hair in the body color. So he represents this physicality. The King of Cups has the spiritual aspect added, so he's got the beard in light blue. There's quite a lot of, you know, the heart chakra colors, whereas here is the spirituality also, but also the red as like the base chakra, and then the other two kings, King of Wands and King of Swords, they bit younger compared to the other two. And that might mean that, you know, there's these are spirited elements. You usually maybe keep a bit younger when you're very airy and very fiery, I'm not sure. But they both have yellow hair, so quite intellectual driven and fiery. And also King of Wands has this red and yellow hat. So red and yellow, like when you think base chakra and solar plexus, like, you know, there's the fire and this passion, whereas King of Swords has quite a spiritual and so light blue and yellow hat as well, so quite spiritual, in quite mental, and he's got the red sword, whereas for example the Page of Swords as the only one in his suit in Doddle, because that varies, he's got the blue sword, so he's not maybe still ready for a battle, he's unsure, and he is quite still spiritual maybe and innocent and mental, he's open, he wants to try different options, whereas then the rest of the sword suit, they have all red swords. So you can play with your deck like this, because I know there are differences in Marseille decks, and not in every deck you will have colors like this, they will be different. But you can check, compare the court cards, you know, when it comes to the age, how their body posture looks like, are they looking to the future, are they looking to the past, are they on the horses, what colors are the horses, you know, what can you notice, like, what's interesting about a certain posture, what the hands are doing. Just try to look at your court cards like this. And think of them often not only as people, but also as a quality that they awaken in you, like what they awaken. And sometimes it might be maybe difficult to connect to those court cards from the traditional decks, because they're so over, like, old in a way. We don't connect to the court people anymore, we don't have queens and kings. But for example, Tarot de Saint Croix, I just took a few different decks to show you. So Tarot de Saint Croix has quite modern take on the courts, and I really enjoy it. There's a few amazing decks that look at court cards in this kind of new exciting way. So we have, and the little booklets, I actually maybe read up some stuff from it. So let's say what she has to say about kings. Well, she doesn't describe kings as in general energy, but it's the last kind of card in the court, so they very important, they like father figure. And very often court cards are also connected to families, so the king becomes like father, queen like a mother, knight and page are son and daughter. Usually page is the feminine, knight is the masculine, queen is the feminine, and king is the masculine. So here we have the King of Cups, and what she writes, the meaning is, you are the master of your emotions, bring forth all that is noble, kind and wise. So that reminds her of her father, Lisa de Saint Croix, because she writes that the king feels and expresses his emotions intensely. And he tenderly holds his dog on his lap, and the boat symbolizes following passion through the storms to a bright outcome. So, you know, everybody sees it a little bit differently. You can often say that the King of Cups can be a drunk also, or like overuse alcohol, because he's always with the big cup, and he can be a great storyteller, he can be a great healer. Often in my readings, the King of Cups, this boat and the fish, like in the Rider-Waite-Smith, came up as a like surprise or something quite nice that happened to me. So just pull daily cards. I think it's really important for you to build a special emotive connotation to the court cards. if it comes to the aspects of our psyche and our personality, that would be like mastering our emotions. So kings is something you have to master. So King of Wands is shown here as an alchemist, because wands is fire and wands is inspiration, and wands are about searching this inspiration and connecting to it. So here the meaning is, by sharing your wisdom you create magic. And I think when you ignite this inner fire within you, when you kind of set your intention onto something, this is the beginning of the great work, and like you've got to know what you want. The King of Swords, he's receiving the sword of truth from the Lady of the Lake here on this card. So are you ready, you know, to be truthful and live by your truth? And here the meaning, Lisa writes, cut through confusion by speaking the truth in a firm and fair way. Stand in the power of your divine right to follow your own mind. So the sword gives you the power and authority through divine right to lead his people with wisdom. So this is a lot of awakens a lot of hints here, like, you know, about the truth, and are you following your truth? How are you living your truth? Are you speaking your truth? Do you feel you have the right to speak up and live by your truth? King of Pentacles, he seems quite hospitable. He's a host, he's sharing his wealth, you know, he's kind of courting his woman here. And what does Lisa write about him? Meaning of this king is, know what you want and how to get it, and enjoy the fruits of your labor. So this is a King Solomon, and he was known for his wisdom as well, for his riches. And here he's shown with the Queen Sheba. So this is the highest aspect of the pentacle suit. So you're abundant and you share your abundance, because abundance, it's a constant flow, it's a state of mind. It's not only always about the riches, but also about how you think about it. And so we had all the kings, and then we move to the queens, and the queens are shown, so Queen of Swords is Athena. There's also a Medusa, which symbolizes the courage to think, you know, and use your wisdom. Queen of Wands is very fiery. There's the sun on the drum, and she's in all the sacral chakra colors, the solar plexus, the base. She's empowered in her sexuality, sensuality. Also Queen of Pentacles, you know, she just enjoys herself, she enjoys her body, she enjoys the moment, smells the roses. And Queen of Cups probably is also amazing, but I forgot to pull her out. The pages are very cute. So they represent different aspects and different stages in the process. So here they are like learning. He's learning at university and trying different stuff out, testing theories. Page of Wands, as you can see, is using his mind and his creativity to like connecting to this divine spark of inspiration. Page of Pentacles, it's like creating different projects and just enjoying the beauty of the world around him. And Page of Cups is shown here on the lotus flower, as this beautiful, gentle bud blooming. So it's very gentle, connecting to emotions, connecting, like exploring spirituality. And then we have the knights, and they also quite differently shown to the regular tarot. So Knight of Swords, you can see how he's with his sword, so with the clarity of his thinking, he can split the dark cloud. So he is bringing understanding, and he can also catch you with his sword, because sometimes truth is uncomfortable. So, you know, this knight is powerful knight. Each of them is powerful. The Knight of Cups, it's very powerful. He's like reaching for the cup, is always flowing, you know, but he's connecting to these emotions. And sometimes emotions can make you feel black and white, but I think the wisdom of the Suit of Cups lies in this, that when we really connect to our emotions, and the white and black stops really existing, because there's shades of shadows, shades of grey, and shades of black, and shades of white. So maybe then when we really connect to our emotions, we're not as judgmental. He also has this mercurial head, so that's a connotation to bringing messages. They all actually, I mean, the Knight of Air and Cups, they both have it. Knight of Wands has shown like a CD, the Indian CD, with Neptune tripod kind of thing and the fire behind him. But it's also shown as the wise spiritual man. So he can use the inside fire to enlighten himself. Then we have the Knight of Pentacles, and he's so grounded. He's surrounded by the sunflower, surrounded by coins kind of looking like pentagrams. He's green, he's ready to blossom, he's ready to grow and expand. So I quite enjoy how Lisa de Saint Croix, in Tarot de Saint Croix, has shown the court cards, because it's quite modern and quite interesting. There's one more deck which I want to show you, and this one is Tarot of Transformation. It's got this amazing book. I love this deck so much. And these guys shown court cards, they renamed them, and they show the quality of the energy that each of the people and the rank would symbolize in your life. So there is a server, and server expresses the impulse to help, whether in the mental, emotional, material, or spiritual arena. This does not have to be a vocational choice, but a simple human one found in everyday realm. So this is the impulse to help. When you are page, in the page stage, you just have this impulse to help, and you are server. So here is the cups, is attending the emotional needs. Discs is a loyal friend, so this impulse to help your friend. Server of Swords is cutting away illusion, so it's quite of a challenge, but it's, you have this impulse to cut through bullshit. And then Server of Wands is transmitter of light, so really notice that divine light within you and how you can use it in your life. So these are servers for pages. And then there's a teacher for knights. So teacher embodies some aspect of the wisdom of a particular suit, or the means by which we learn. So this is maybe how we learn. So teacher of discs speaks about passionate play and encourages us to learn for playing. Teacher of cups, it's exploring the inner landscape, so it's allowing yourself to feel. Teacher of swords, inquiring mind, so here you learn through studying, learning, researching. Here you can learn through, you know, like just feeling. And teacher of wands is spirit in matter. So this is bringing kind of seeing maybe the spiritual in mundane. And then there's the healer. Healer exerts a healing influence, whether on others or on oneself. So these are the queens. So this is healer of discs, is a very important part of healing the planet. So this is also about healing maybe our body, because this is a microcosmos and macrocosmos. Healer of cups is healing the inner child. And then healer of swords is about mapping the mind, which I love. And healer of wands is vibrational healing. So different aspects to healing. And that's the queens. And then the master is the king. It's the most comprehensive expression, building on all of the previous lessons and representing an integral whole. He or she is an expression of refined perception, swords, mastery in the material realm, discs, emotional maturity, cups, and actualized life on spiritual path, wands. We could say that the combination of these four master cards is symbolized in the card 21, the cosmos, so in the world card. So we have the king of this, master of this, gracious abundance. So you work with abundance, but you're constantly connected to it. It's never like just stagnated and stuck in your bank account somewhere. Master of Cups, abiding in love. So this is this highest aspect of love. Master of Swords is reading the web. So this is like really understanding how the mental creates different, how our thought can create our reality and just seeing it. And then the Master of Wands is Temple of the Goddess. So that's quite interesting, but here, you know, like all this flower of life everywhere, it's just like being alive and bringing this spirit to matter and to our bodies and working in unity with it. So that's quite fascinating for the court cards. That's from more psychological, spiritual perspective. If I was to choose how I read the court cards, I love to read them not as people as much as the aspects of our psychological personality and aspects of life, also as the stages in a process. So that's what Barbara Moore, when I see a page, I know that I have to learn something. When I see a knight, I know that I have to do something quickly. When I see a queen, I know that I have to nurture something. And when I see a king, I know that I have to master something and control something. I hope it was helpful. It's a long one for me. You can skip parts of it if you're not enjoying it, but I just wanted to get it across. And if you have any questions, just write and I try to answer them. And enjoy your weekend. Bye.